Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for Need and Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. We did have another video cross 5,000 likes, putting us at 162 now, only 18 away from all Beastie Week. And that is going to include random run days and any other random characters we decide to throw in there during that 7-day stretch, which I am looking forward to. And if you want to see it happen sooner, make sure you get these videos over 5,000 likes. Go check out the other ones. We have like 3 other videos from the previous week that are teetering on the cusp of 5,000 likes, so go check them out. And thank you for those of you who already have. Easy for me to say. It's a Monday, you know. We're just getting started. New week, new adventures, new everything. Here's your meme of the day. Speaking of new, brought to you by JD Riad. I wanted to say JD Royd, but it's actually JD Riad, like R-I-O-D. Title thread was in Sissy We Trust. What gives people feelings of power? Money? Status? Sorry. Yeah, that bottom bar needs to be stretched like another like 10 feet there on that page. So thank you very much to JD Riad and all 120 of you who upvoted that one. Happy Monday in the mosh pit, everybody. Here we go. Alpha Mike 4-8, 6 kilo 6-9. We've got Berserk. Good tiers, decent damage, little Chad, terrible movement speed. 0.90 is real bad. That's like real like wow bad. We also have Berserk, which is not recharging because we're not dealing any damage right now. But we also have Diplopia here. Now, Diplopia kind of it's kind of tickling my fancy a little bit. And I don't really want to phrase it like that, but it is kind of making me think. You know, there's a lot of early game stuff that you can do with Diplopia, including getting free Devil Deals while still maintaining your Angel Deal. Getting yourself free shops, etc., etc. That kind of stuff is all kinds of good. We get Puberty, which, I mean, like, Puberty is, you can get the Adult Transformation for sure, and I think it gives you an HP upgrade. So we'll just go ahead and take it. I don't know if the secret room is here or not. It could be. Yeah, okay. We get a golden key. Okay, all right now. Okay now. Also get ourselves a Bomba. So lots of red hearts here, and if little Chad actually pays out for us, we could potentially get ourselves a sacrifice room play. So you see me here using Berserk. We're gonna try to hurry up here, not because I'm in a hurry, but because obviously I want to try to maximize the uptime on Berserk's damage potential. And we were able to beat down Fruity Plum pretty easily, or Baby Plum, whatever the heck her name is. There you go. Little Chad, by the way, is a familiar that's going to follow us and give us lots of kisses like these. He will give us a bunch of... Ooh, I didn't even see that. Got a tears up here. Very nice. He will give us the kisses in the forms of the half red hearts. And it's very good. It's very, very good to have, especially if you're trying to make yourself a good sacrificial room play early on like we are going to try to do anyway. Isaac stuck out his toe one too far there. If we can get the Berserk... No, we should probably say Berserk. Berserk, by the way, is basically Tainted Samson's unlock. It essentially just turns you into Tainted Samson for a little bit. And you can extend the timer by killing things. It's very, very good. There we go. So I am going to use one bomb here to get this nickel. So we're working towards Diplopia. Now, there are plenty of red hearts to go around right now. Let's just say that for a second. I don't know if it's enough for us to really be able to capitalize on all of the drops from a sacrifice room, but we can pretend. Because we have increased angel chance. I think the next 2 taps will result in a possible angel deal. I hope. I'm going to go actually all the way back to the boss room. Just because I want to, there are PJs here too, which is going to give us 4 soul hearts and a full heal, by the way. So, you know, it really comes down to whether or not we want to sacrifice all the soul hearts that that PJs gives us or not. I think that if, you know, with a start like this early on, you gotta go for the gusto, right? Surely. 50% for a random chest here. Okay. Off to a good start here. It's definitely feeling and looking like a Monday in here. I'm going to go back and get this half red heart real fast. So will this sacrifice... I mean, I'm not going to lie, Game, you're not really pushing the motivation here for me to keep on going with the sack room if you're just not going to give us literally anything. 33% chance for teleport to the angel room. Or we can just get a chest. All right, man. Boy, howdy. So we have not gotten the angel deal item now. So now it comes down to whether or not we want to, do we want to use these soul hearts from PJs or not? It gives us a lot of HP. It gives us a lot of room to wiggle with. The potential there is that we can get these soul hearts back, right? I think we got to go for it. We do get the soul heart back. I'm going to pick up the warfly just to get it off the freaking ground here. Just want to do that to limit the bombs from dropping. We're not going to fight Uriel right now. We are just, I'm just not feeling it. We got 30 cents. I could come in here with Diplopia and also Diplope. All of these, but I'm not going to do that. So unfortunately, we did not get the 7 soul hearts, and we basically got nothing except money out of that. But I will take Diplopia. I will take that. We say goodbye to Berserk. I know that Berserk is kind of an underused item, and I recognize that. But at the same time, I think that Diplopia gives us a better chance at just a better run overall. And Berserk, while it is good, it does tend to run out very quickly. Immediately go straight for the arcade. Figured why not. So Diplopia is going to double everything in a room, but it's a single time. It's a one-time use item. You can do a variety of different things with it. The main motivation behind taking Diplopia here, Warfly, please. Thank you. I want to try to get a devil deal, a couple devil deal items, hopefully within this first devil deal here. Without actually getting the devil deal precedent, and then we can go switch it up for a for an angel deal. Right now, we definitely need some damage, and if you ever want to start dropping us pills, by the way, Game, I'm just saying. I mean, I know that the bias is there that you don't really want to give us pills because we've got PhD and that would be good for us and kind of fun, but let me know when you want to spawn us a pill, and I will be more than happy to take it off your hands for you. I don't know why we still have the Locust of War. Usually I would have just yeeted that by now. Give me Monstro. Monstro 1. No, it's going to be double red Monstro. That is not what I was hoping for. That's a double red Monstro. They have bigger eyes now, thanks to the new sprite updates. And they're just as annoying and dangerous as ever. So you got to try to keep them on the same side and try to get them synced up. Otherwise, if you get in between them, you're gonna have a bad time. Now, fortunately, Monstros, they cannot hurt each other. Although that would be very hilarious and very fun and good for us, didn't work like that. Okay, once you get one of the red Monstros down, the other one is just a piece of cake. And ironically, Monstro would make the best cake to model after Isaac Boss of in the entire game, in my opinion. Except maybe Hush, I guess, but I think Monstro would be more recognizable, just more loved. Get a range upgrade. And boy, howdy. What a devil deal here. Thank you. Thank you, Stan. Seriously. Thank you. I mean, Ouija board is not a bad... It's not a bad item. Like, we get the spectral tears and everything, but it's not 3 soul hearts good, especially with us having Diplopia. I'm not going to rip Diplopia on that. Okay, Warfly. I'm sorry. Not sorry, but you got to go. Bloody Gust. Bloody Gust is going to give us a damage and tears and movement speed upgrade. Not damage. Bloody Lust is the one that gives us damage. So we were able to get back in the soul heart department here, which I do appreciate. We can't find any pills, however. Oh, there we go. Get a tears up pill. And a tears up pill. Which means that one of those was a tears down. All right, so we got a good foundation for a phenomenal run going right now. We just gotta, I'm gonna find the store because all stores become viable with Diplopia, especially if we end up getting super lucky and we end up finding a member card, get down to the secret shop, and then we can rip Diplopia in there and just get a whole bunch of free stuff, good free stuff for, you know, free. Everyone liking yesterday's random run day. It was definitely, it was a lot of fun, man. Like, we got really lucky on that, on those payouts. But, you know, booster pack, in my opinion, is not worth the, it's not good enough for us to use the, I have to buy this pill. I can't pretend like I know what it is because I don't remember. Yeah, booster pack is not worth, in my opinion, using Diplopia on. Really, the bare minimum standard for when I use Diplopia in a shop, it has to give me at least two premium items that I want. Not just one. Another range up here, and we are just swimming in HP right now. Now, if only we could get damage. That's what we really, really need. I will take the Rotten Heart just for the fly. We'll head on down. Recently opened a couple of boxes of the Magic the Gathering Kamigawa set, and man, that it might be my new favorite Magic set. Like, I really, really, really like Dominaria and Koria from when they did the Godzilla collab. But man, I gotta say, Kamigawa is really, really awesome, man. And we ended up pulling, those of you who follow me on Twitter, you would have already seen this, but man, we ended up pulling the showcase mythic rare of the Wandering Emperor foil, which is like a $200 or $300 card, something like that. Everyone was going insane. And I was like, man, like that, it's got me. It's got me. Now I gotta start playing Magic again. Which is hilarious because, okay, it's not hilarious, but which is apt. Because I've been wanting to get back into Magic for a while, but haven't really had the urge to until like a new set comes out. And like, if I really like the cards, for me, like, I'm a collector first off, more so than an actual player of Magic. And I was told a long time ago that, you know, you can't really be like, Magic cards are not Pokemon cards, right? Like, they don't collect as well as Pokemon cards do. Plus, like I'm actually familiar with Pokemon, but I will say that when the new set comes out, Magic's pretty darn fun. I've had a lot of fun on Magic. So I got a collector's box. We ripped that on stream, and that's in the second pack. I pulled the Wandering Emperor showcase art, and the rare foil. Lots of other alt arts in there. It's such a great set. I wish I was opening some right now. It's a good time to be a card collector. You know, whether it be Pokemon, Magic, Star Wars, you know, which of course I collect all those sports cards if that's your fancy. Sports cards, man, like sports cards are so overpriced. You know, at least Pokemon and stuff are coming back down in price, thankfully. Now that the demand has still been high, but the production has gone up from the Pokemon company. So this is going to give us the adult transformation, which does give us the HP upgrade, which is what I thought. Still looking for our item room. That's all I really care about. So now Isaac has the adult transformation, which makes him look really weird. Little Chad, you know what? I appreciate your enthusiasm. I really do. I'm glad you're here. We haven't really been talking about you a whole lot. Of course, little Chad and D-Bizzle make the tag team duo. Well, theoretically anyway, depending on D-Bizzle's mood. Lots and lots of pills. Bad gas. See, now this is the good stuff now. This is what I want. I want to get me some good pills. And 4.84 tears rate's great. I think we can chill on the tears rate pills for now and start looking for movement speed, hopefully. Yeah, movement speed. It's really the only stat that we want at this point. I mean, our tiers rate is about to be maxed. I just don't feel like doing that room. Well, at least I didn't have to pay a key to get in there. So no sacrifice room, unfortunately. Lots and lots of HP. Holding out hope that... yes, I'm being super lazy. Holding out hope that we can get a good devil deal here. We just need damage at this point. 2.88 damage is just horrible. It's like that's like torturous, you know? I'm actually impressed that we have managed to kill all three of those bomb flies in here, like singularly, individually. How about that? That's a much better choice of word there. So we get Pestilence, which is going to give us Cuban meat, not ball bandages, or it might give us ball bandages, which I will immediately call Cuban meat anyway. Again, it's a Monday. The brain's not warmed up, you know. It's like it's. I mean, yes, I am recording this on Sunday, but still, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. It's the curse of recording fresh daily content for you here on YouTube every single day, 7 days a week, delivered to your doorstep for the low, low cost of free. But if you want to pay me back, just click the like button. That's the best way to do it. It's the best way to support the channel. I tell you, it's beautiful. It's a simple solution. We do get ball of bandages, not Cuban meat. And, thank you, Stanley. Caves 2. You know, it's the game's trying to give us devil deals, and I appreciate the effort, game. I really do. But, like, if you don't give us any good... or even mediocre items that are worth, like, sacrificing our HP or using Diplopia for, then are you really giving us devil deals? Because I feel like you're not. Does this work with Diplopia? Does butter and Diplopia work and give you infinite Diplopia? I can't imagine that working. That's got to be a hugely broken combo, I would imagine. So we did get tagged there, and Bloody Gust did finally kick off. Fortunately, it does not increase our damage and increase our movement speed. I will hold on to the Butter Trinket. The Butter Trinket is going to drop our active item whenever we use it. Or it has a chance to drop our... It has a chance to drop a passive item, I think. It has a chance to drop one of the items. It's a good block there by Ball Bandages. I'm not even going to try to pretend like I did that on purpose. And a greed fight. All right. Okay, well, we got some money back. One bomb gets us 2 sacks here. Get a Joker card. Okay, well, at least we can guarantee our Joker card. One bomb gets us another 2 sacks right here. Lots of full charges. Not gonna take the cursed penny. Okay, so we know that we're gonna get a devil deal here no matter what. Or I guess technically speaking, the Joker card could potentially take us to an angel deal. I'd be surprised, but there is a chance. But But if we can just get some damage ups, that'd be great. That'd be muy bueno. Like, necesito mucho, mucho, mucho damage-o. Por favor-o. Okay, extinguish the fire so we have an actual escape route just in case. Oh, it's nice when you can time the orbital to actually do something useful for once. What was that? The Isaac physics engine freaking out a little bit there. We get damage, thank God. And I am going to use the Joker card here. Going to be Succubus. So again, I don't want to. I do not want to use Diplopia on a single item. I think that that's a big waste. Unless if it's a Guppy item or something like that, I think that's just a huge waste. So we do get a damage upgrade. Thank. Largely in part to Jesus Juice. Of course, Succubus is also going to give us a damage aura that we can step into, but obviously she's not going to stick around forever, because she, like, you know, bounces all over the place. So there is a sacrifice room here, and I mean, you know, we are in desperate times, calls for desperate measures sort of territory. Even though our stats are looking better, but 3.80 damage is not good, and we have lots. We have lots and lots of HP to throw out here, so I am going to take a risk and go for broke here, and maybe we'll get lucky and get an Angel Deal item. We are super duper fast. Perks, hey, that's actually really good, because we can half the damage in here. 33% chance for an Angel Deal item, and we get a Soul Heart. Okay. Two clubs doubles our bombs. Again, I want to maintain the perks in here, so I am gonna stick with in here and fight Uriel, even though we have a double deal precedent already. We want 7 soul hearts here, and we got them. Very nice. And we might as well fight Gabriel now too. That perks pill was huge. Perks, by the way, is going to have all of our damage. So instead of us paying for one full heart in the sack room, we only paid half. And because we got the 7 soul hearts back, that means that we made back almost all the HP that we spent. But you're seeing the damage problem that we're running into currently is getting worse and worse. We need to, I mean, Succubus is helping us for sure, but, you know, Diplopia, we need to find a good solution for Diplopia at this point. Go in the curse room, why not? Oh, baby. Lots and lots of payouts here. Now, you may notice that the Bloody Gust did trigger whenever we damaged ourselves on the Cursed Room door. So, you know, it's a good solution if you do have the HP for it. It's a good way to get yourself a little bit of a boost for movement speed and tears, while also accomplishing something that you would have been doing anyway, which was going into a Cursed Room, unless you don't have the HP for it, obviously. Succubus helping us out a little bit. Of course, Succubus' aura also will deal damage based on our base damage, but that doesn't say much because our base damage is kind of bad. Kind of really bad. It's almost wow bad, I would say. Not World of Warcraft bad. I mean, like, WoW bad. Like, wow, that is bad. We could have played the judgment, the key judgment. Oh wow, this is champion fistula. This is a black champion fistula. I don't think I've ever seen it before. I like it. Okay, I'm gonna go back and let's find the shop. Let's find the item room. Ooh boy, this is. Yeah, I think the game knows that it gave us an early diplopia. Now at this point, is just trolling us. I'm going to find out what happens when you mix butter with diplopia, though. Trying to stay in the succubus aura as much as possible here so we can maximize our damage for what little there is. Okay, we can still push the dingas onto the spikes. We get a little monstro. Now, when in doubt, little monstro is here to bail you out. All right, so 73% here for a deal with the devil. It's gonna be Reap Creep. Reap Creep, I don't think there's a champion Reap Creep, is there? This one looks a little, it looks darker, it looks grayer for some reason. Got a full spread of little monstrous shots right there. And that is a 73% deal with the devil miss. Womp, 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 womp. All right. So our first floor diplopia, looking real good now. It's looking super, super duper. I mean, we could have used it on Ouija board. Shoulda, coulda, woulda, but we didn't. Get a range up. Range up. The lovers. There's our full card. Not that we have a chance of getting into boss rush. At least not on this lap anyway. But if you think we're doing a victory lap, I don't know what gave you the idea that we're gonna even try. Let's put it this way: we're gonna have to have some kind of Christmas miracle here for us to get powerful enough for us to get to do a victory lap. You know, I am happy that we have at least been getting somewhat of a decent payout from devil deals. Ooh. You know, two daddy long legs is not, that's not terrible. And eternal heart as well. Hey, long legs, of course, is going to stomp on stuff. School bag.
Health up.
I don't think we want school bag. It's spades, doubles our keys. Or sorry, it creates keys out of enemies. No, it's way too late for that. At this point, money is useless, so we're just gonna go for broke here. And We're going to save Diplopia for either the devil deal, or at this point, like, we might as well just save it for the chest. You know, because at least we're going to get four more chests out of it. It wasn't really my intention to save Diplopia all the way up through the chest, but that's just kind of how things have shaped out. Nice kill there by Daddy Longlegs. And we should be full health for the next floor here. And you see I love when I'm just watching the enemy's health bar just disappear whenever little Monstro's full blast of shots goes off. It's so great. Little Monstro's good, man. Like, he's just a good follower. Especially since you can launch his tears almost as if Isaac had Monstro's lung himself. There we go. Good job, little Monstro. We do get our devil deal, and it's going to be Mark and Purgatory. Okay. Yeah, at this point, I think it's honestly just better that we just save it for the chest. I was tempted to use it there because I want to see what happens when we get Butter and Diplopia. But that's kind of a bad way to just waste Diplopia if it doesn't work. Epic Fetus. Sure, why not? Why not, Epic Fetus? Come on down. You know, at least with Epic Fetus, we're going to have a little bit of more damage than what we've been having, so... And we can also skip through rooms that we don't want to be in. Like that one. Or this one. Or this one. Or this one. Or that one. Or this one. Or this one. All right. Or this one. By God. Or this one. Or this one. Or this one. Or this one. I mean, wait. Come on now. We gotta clear this one. You the man, Purgatory. You the man. Wait, blast assist? Okay. Apparently, Blast Assist just blasts himself whenever he splits like that straight towards Isaac. That's a new one for me. You know what? Give me the marrow. Give me marrow or give me death. That would have worked for an Eddie Izzard sketch, right? Marrow death. No soul heart there from the tinted Raku. I don't like this room. I don't like it. Thank you, Purgatory and Daddy Longlegs. This is another room that is made almost impossible to destroy with having Epic Fetus at your helm. Get a damage upgrade here. Womb 2. Like how the doppelganger just stands there and just accepts his fate. As he should. We're gonna have to get out of this Globin room in a hurry. This one here. Thank you, Day Long Legs. Actually wasn't planning on clearing that room, but I'll take it. Secret room here. Yeah, might as well look for magic mush as well. Pheromones, what is this? Infested and perks. It'll take me some perks. Perks again is going to give us the wafer effect for a room, which halves all damage. I mean, we could really, if you wanted to, we could play the sacrifice room, especially if we end up getting some more red hearts on the ground with this perks pill. I like that idea. We're going to lose a lot of HP here, but honestly, I'm here for it. Got Jesus juice again. Okay. We get. Well, we finally got our angel deal. And boy, howdy, was it a good one. Now, unfortunately, that did eat our perks pill. Yeah, that was not worth it, I would say. But hey, you know what? It gave us a little bit of excitement on this run. Wow. I'm actually really surprised that the explosion didn't take out that eye laser there. And also, kind of unfortunate that Purgatory has put itself in a position that we can't readily hit, but that's all right. That was a 73% deal with the Angel Mist. Not that it matters, because we've already been in there. And yeah, I think it's safe to say we're pod committed on Diplopia at this point. Okay, all right. It is a Hanukkah miracle that we didn't get hit in that room. I don't know how we didn't. I didn't even, like, I couldn't even keep up with how many, like, leapers there were. Like, I was just, like, praying that we're not going to get hit here. Golden Heart doesn't really do much for us, but hey, it's there. I will go play this Judgment. And obviously we're going to be wanting a solid HP upgrade here. Or a couple Soul Hearts. I wouldn't turn that down either. Or we could just get like the worst possible item that we could have not hoped for. That's fine too. Mondays. Monday, gonna lose some time on Monday. Every devil deal that we get is bad. Monday. Playing Eden on Monday. Wish we had some time to get soul hearts. Dying and dying, yeah. Fun. Looking forward to the dead ends. All right. There we go. There's the north, west, and south side of the map. Let's go check out the other south side of the map now. Oh, boy. This room just looks... It's a whole lot of dookie in this room. Just a whole bunch of dookie. Champion Red Duke, to be precise. Thank God we've got AoE in here. Hey, there's still one singular fly left. How tragic it would have been had we had to do that entire room over because of one singular black fly. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. All we gotta do is just make it to the chest. Bunny would really help us out here if he dropped less than three. He didn't. Super secret room. No. All right. Well, we've come this far, team. And, you know, we've been waiting. We've been waiting with this Diplopia play for a while now. And I have no doubt that once we're done beating Isaac down, that we will be rewarded with our patience, for our patience, with an amazing item and lots of easy times ahead, right? 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 Right. All right, get our half soul heart so we, at least we can get to Polar Invincibility. And here we go. All right. Now is when our time is now. We have two mega chests here, which are bound to probably eat all of our keys before we even get a payout. But was it worth it? Let's find out. Yeah. 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 Whoo, boy. All right. Well, we did get the Book of Revelations. Diplopia did not work with our butter, by the way. Mongo baby, come on down. Ipecac, I don't even know what Ipecac does with Epic Fetus anymore, so we're just going to take it. Just say, I mean, hell, why not? And, you know, we've got some damage now, right? For some reason, our shield is green. But hey, at least we got the Book of Revelations. Book of Revelations is going to at least give us some kind of HP upgrade. Albeit temporarily. We are doing poison. Actually, now that I think about it, we have had Ipecac and Epic Fetus before. I didn't actually want that that heart, because that's going to ruin our Polar Invincibility. The poison gas cloud that we're getting out of Ipecac and Epic Fetus is pretty nice. I cannot lie. Butterbean, not exactly the premier item that we're looking for. All right. So there's the east and west, or the east and south side of the map. So for those of you who are playing along, make sure you don't go this side. And I don't know if having Epic Fetus and Ipecac together is worse or better than having one or the other by themselves. I mean, we're doing a butt ton of damage right now, that's for sure. That's undeniable. But is it more or less dangerous to Isaac himself? This room is not going to be fun. You cannot lose track of the Monstros, otherwise you're going to have a bad time. All right, now goes Monstro. I have a feeling that this is a dead end up here, but against my better judgment, I'm going to go up here anyway. No, maybe not. Well, if it is, we haven't found it yet. We are doing a pretty good amount of damage, though. Finally starting to get a little bit of help here on our HP. The big Chad. Turns into little Chad whenever you kill him. Well, damage him anyway. Definitely want to take out Fallen first. Fallen represents the bigger threat. Hey, we did find the boss. Yellow Champion Mega Fatty. There we go. So we are probably going to get the dub here unless we have some kind of monumental collapse. But you know what? Shout out to Epic Fetus for stepping it up. I really think that it was we would have been in trouble up until the chest. Do I think that we could have beaten Isaac without Epic Fetus? It's tough to say, man. Comment below. Let me know what you think would have happened had we not taken Epic Fetus. Do you think we would have actually gotten it or not? I think it would have been a lot harder, but I would have had to concentrate a little bit more had we not had Epic Fetus in the Isaac fight. But either way, what a good way to start off the week here. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, and for those of you who are new members of the Mosh Pit, highly encourage you to check out the links down below. Go check out our Discord. If you want to join the Mosh Pit MVPs, you can go do so down below as well. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Dennis Zubko, Avia, Michael McMaster, Oliver Wendt, Ashlyn West, and Drake Von Lowers. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/sinvicta.